Here is another video in the series of talent interview Q&A, and this is part number 8, and this is all regarding TMAP in talent. So before we proceed any further, if you have any questions, drop those in the comment section below. And as I always say, share the knowledge, and if you like the video, give me a thumbs up, and I wish you good luck and happy learning. So let's get started. So the very common question in TMAP is regarding that parallel lookup. So if you have multiple tables used as a lookup, the interviewer may ask you how can we enable parallel lookup so that all the lookup tables start, you know, caching as soon as we start the job, right? So we will you know, look at this in real time. And the next question would be, how do you you know, handle all the data type conversion even without using tconvert type component, right? There's a component already that does that, but he may ask you how to do this auto data type conversion without the use of tconversion type component. So that is another question. And there could be a few questions on how do you you know, use the fuzzy match in TMAP. Right, when your source and target columns are different, you'll not be able to you know, auto map it. And when you have like hundreds of columns, you may be, you know, challenging. It's very challenging to map all those 100 columns. So he may ask you, how do we you know, set the fuzzy match in the TMAP for the auto map feature. So let's start looking at the first one, the parallel lookup. Let me go to Talent Studio. So before I enable that option, I wanted to show you how does a regular lookup will work. So as you see, there is first lookup, and there are two lookups having high amount of records here. So let me show you how it works. And if you carefully observe, this is the starting, right? This is the first lookup. It will first read everything, and then the second lookup will start, and then the main flow will start, right? Now I'm gonna kill this job, and I'm gonna enable parallel lookup so that the lookup 1, 2, and even if you have like 10 different lookups for the same TMAP, you can have all those 10 lookup you know, tables start caching as soon as you start the execution. So for that, you can get into TMAP, and there's a small little icon here on the top. This is the configuration. This is where you set the lookup in parallel, right? And if the table is heavy, you can set the temporary data, you know, directory path. So this is where it'll temporarily store all the, you know, records into memory. Right, so this is the setting, lookup in parallel, and this is available only in the enterprise version, and this is one of the common you know, question in interview to test your knowledge whether you have really worked in the enterprise tool or not. So now I'll show you, when I start the job, you will see the table 1 and table 2 will start caching the records as soon as I hit execute. See, both lookups have started caching. Everything is complete, and it started running. Right, so this will be very useful in one of the performance tuning aspect also. If the table are heavy, then it'll be lookup will be really slow. Right, let me stop this. In my case, I have the database, everything in the local, so it is faster. But in real time scenario, you may have very slow lookups, which is causing too much of delay, right? So this comes in handy. All right, so let's check the second one. So second one was the auto data type conversion. So similarly, we have enabled this thing, right? Lookup in parallel. The next option here is enable auto conversion of types. So this will actually help us automatically convert the data type conversion. So in this case, it's actually a string data type, but if you have your input as, you know, int, and your target is having long int, then usually if you don't check that, you will get data type conversion errors, which will not even let you execute your job. So in those cases, you can automatically use enable auto conversion of types. So you don't have to necessarily use tconvert type component. You can directly do that conversion right here. Right, so this is the second question. So what was the third one in our presentation? So it's regarding the fuzzy match in the TMAP. So I have this simple talent job in which I'll show you how fuzzy match in TMAP works. So for that, just get into TMAP. And when you're really working with totally different systems, you may have a real-time scenario wherein the column name from your source are totally different than your target, right? And also, if you have like hundreds of columns, mapping manually will really take a lot of time, and also there could be a lot of manual errors, right? For example, I just dragged onto the different columns, so this is an error. So in order to avoid this manual error and also time-consuming activity, so there is a TMAP auto map feature, right? So the auto map feature works only when there are exactly same column names, right? So in order to address this, to have this fuzzy match, again we will have to go to this TMAP configurations. And if you see currently the auto map, the fuzzy match is currently at exact match. So when it is exactly matching, then only it will do it. Otherwise it won't do the auto map. So what we can do is we can make use of simple match. And I'll show you because I have made some bigger changes, so it will not be accurate. So let's see how simple match works. See, with the simple match, we're able to map these two columns automatically, right? And region name is region and order ID is order number. So, but other columns are not mapped, right? So for that reason, what you can do, you can just go with full Livingston. And now if you click auto map, see the remaining columns are also mapped correctly. And the last one is so off, date of birth, and is just a BIRT, right? So if you have even more complicated column names to be mapped, even make use of full jacquard or super fuzzy. So this will really help you when you have like hundreds of columns that you need to be mapped. Right, so this is the third point for today's session. I hope you liked it and happy learning.